Hi, it's Yoni.
Hi, it's Sammy.
And we're reviewing the movie
Snake Eyes. G.I. Joe Origins.
Yeah, it was a 2-hour long movie.
How do you know how long it is?
I checked, and it was the third, I think, in the G.I. Joe series.
Yeah, I think
first one in a long time.
It's probably the best one. I liked the Mortal Kombat one better.
I think this was the last G.I. Joe movie was in 2014. So
2013.
So it's been a long time.
I think this movie is supposed to come out in 2020. But lots of movies got pushed off.
Yeah, so it's about the origin of one of the G.I. Joe heroes named Snake Eyes. And it talks about what happened to him when he was a little boy, which happens to a lot of superheroes when they're little boys. Bad things happen to their parents, and they have to take revenge. It takes them a long time to get revenge.
I'm not going to spoil anything.
Yeah,
they roll dice. They get snake eyes.
Yeah, so this was a violent movie. A lot of people dying, but no gore or anything. There wasn't a lot of profanity or anything.
Oh, there's a scene. I don't know if this might ruin the, jump scare for you. There's a scene with a snake.
Yeah, there were giant snakes that were kind of scary. That was the only thing I think that was scary in the movie.
Hopefully that didn't ruin anyone's
jump scare. But it goes through a lot of the classic action hero formulas where, the bad guy is, the good guy is kind of a loner who just wants to seek revenge, but ends up getting involved in fighting crime.
Pretty much. Okay.
Fighting bad guys and using lots of karate and lots of swords. They don't like to use guns for some reason.
There was one scene where, He shot at the person, and then he just moves his right. He had, a bunch of people on him. I thought that was pretty stupid. Mm-hmm.
It took place in a Japanese neighborhood in L.A., where there's Yakuza gang members, and eventually you get introduced to the Cobras, who are the G.I. Joe villains, and and you get to meet some of the characters from G.I. Joe, including Scarlett O'Hara.
Scarlett
O'Hara, and
it's kind of like the new Shang-Chi, it's coming out this fall.
Right, Shang-Chi is coming out too, and that's also an action movie with lots of karate and stuff.
I think it's I'm surprised they didn't show the trailer for it.
So how many stars would you give this movie out of 5? Well, let's say out of 5, usually they count out of 5.
3.5.
I would give it 2 stars. I don't think there was a lot of originality. I don't think the dialogue was original or the characters or the plot.
It's all
stuff that we've seen a million times before in action movies.
like Ryan the Last Dragon and a deeper meaning.
Yeah. So I would recommend it for younger viewers.
Plus.
Well, I think maybe it's a movie that 10-year-old boys like you would like.
I'm turning 10 tomorrow.
Yeah, tonight.
Yeah, I didn't want to watch it. I wanted to watch it before it came out. I didn't want to spend my birthday. Mm-hmm. My birthday is...
Tomorrow is Sammy's birthday. He's going to be 10 years old.
I did this review before Jeremy Jans and other famous movie critics.
I think Sammy's the right demographic for this movie. Adolescent boys, I think, will like it. I don't think it's for younger children who might get a little scared, but I don't think it's for older people who've already seen this kind of movie 10 million times and will be bored from it.
Me, you think I would be the right?
Yeah, I think you're the right age. I would recommend it for boys from 10 to 15.
Are lots of girls in the theater?
And there were some. Okay, so I think that's all we have to say about Shang-Chi. Snake Eyes. Snake Eyes.
Our next review will be...
Probably Shang-Chi.
Old.
Or old, if we see old. I don't know, what's old rated?
Talk about that later.
Happy